Hey everyone, this is the next video in our series about Pivotal Cloud Foundry tutorials. In this video, we are going to set up the environment, means we are going to install the PCF CLI, PCF command line installation, right? So that we can create our own our local machine to work with Pivotal Cloud Foundry. So let's go ahead and get started. What we have to do to do this, first we have to install the PCF CLI, right? So let's go ahead and see how we can do that. This is the URL for Pivotal platform where you can get all the resources related to PCF, right? So we have to install the PCF CLI. So these are the two options: try Pivotal platform on the public cloud or try Pivotal platform on your workstation. So these are the two options. So we are interested in on this public cloud, which is available with them. This is for the application where you want to set up your own, in your workstation you want to set up the PCF environment, the Cloud Foundry environment, right? So we are interested in this one, so I'm going ahead and clicking this get started. So this is the page that we got here. So you have to jump to install the PCF CLI, right? And here you can see the different options, and you can see you can choose whatever applicable for you. I am on the download for Windows 64, so this is applicable for me, so I'm going ahead and installing this, right? So this is the very small file, 5.9 MB, you can get it directly. So go ahead and extract this. After extracting the zip, you will get this folder, and inside this you will get CF installer. You can double click this one to install it. Anyone who uses this computer, okay, install cf.txt, right? So setup has just finished, so I'm good to go now, right? So if I go to Windows E directory and here this PC, Windows C, it installed. Just to check the installation was correct or not, so you have to see Cloud Foundry, and yes, this is the place where this has installed, right? cf.exe and all this. So what you have to do, you have to check the environment variables. Environment variables, and here see the path edit. Okay, here you will see I already have set this path, C program files Cloud Foundry. While installation, it is possible that it gets set automatically, but if it is not setting automatically, you go to your this installer, this directory where it is installed, you copy this path, right, and set it on environment variable. Put this here, right? So what is the benefit of this? I'm just going to explain you. So you know the environment variables, right? So we will get this benefit. So if I can go to command prompt and see, use the PCF CLI, so to check if the installation is proper or not, you have to put CF and help, right? If you enter this command and you are seeing these options, right, all the commands, cf help hyphen a, means it is going to list you all the commands that are available with Cloud Foundry and what you can do with this, right? So version, logout, login, logout, all these options you can. So if it is working properly, it means cf Cloud Foundry is installed on your local machine and you are good to go, right? So if you want to check the version, so you can, what version of CLI you have installed, so you can see that from here, right? You can see right here. So next command for us is CF login. PCF is an environment, right? So to work with, to do anything with that environment, you have to log into that environment, right? So I have command CF login, so I have to just enter it. And this is the API endpoint, HTTPS API run pivotal.io, where by default it is pointing, right? So this is the place where from where you can access the Pivotal environment, right? So their apps, whatever installed there, whatever spaces are there, how many applications are running over there, and how can you post there. First you have to log in, so you have to give email. So before login you have to register with them. So let's go ahead and see how we can register with them. Again we have to come to this page right here, and if you see, here is the link for the sign in. Go here, you do not have account, create an account, right? These are the basic details that you have to give and sign up. So you go ahead and register with this. I already have registered with them, so I'm going ahead and signing directly, right? So this is the mail ID with which I have registered. Click next. Enter the password. The password, right? And click sign in. Probably you will see this page. So click on the Pivotal web services. We are interested on this. So there are different things provided by the Pivotal network, portal, support. You can click on the different one and see this, right? I'm here. So when you will click, probably when you are logging, you will see the different pages, right? So let me show you. I have taken the screenshot of those pages, right? So I'm on this page, registration, and the next I'm going to show you the org and spaces. What are these? When you have signed up with them, you will see, because PCF is not free, it is to use the full-fledged services, you have to sign up, you have to pay them for the services that they are providing, right? But they are providing the trial period that you can take advantage of, right? So you have to claim your trial, you have to enter these details, right? Country and mobile number, right? So when you will enter this, you will get a code in your system, in your mobile number, and you have to enter that, right? So when you send that, so you will see, receive the code, enter your receive code and submit this one, right? So when you submit this, you will get the option to create org, right? Create org. So in my system, I am on this system, right? So I am going to ahead and creating the org. So before creating org, let's go ahead and see what is this org all about. An org is a development account that an individual or multiple collaborators can own and use. So single person or a team can work on our org, right? So a collaborator access an org with user accounts that they have, which have roles. So any user that is logging into the PCF and into any org, they have some role. They can have org manager, org auditor, or org billing manager, right? So these are the different roles that can be have. Collaborators in an org share a resource quota, plan, apps, service availability, and custom domains. These are the things that they share. By default, an org has the status of active, but when you log in as an org manager, org auditor, and org billing manager, you can change the status of those org. Right? An admin can set the status of an org suspended to vary for various reasons, such as failure to provide payment or misuse of the org. When an org is suspended, users cannot perform certain activities within the org, such as push apps, modify spaces, or bind services. So this is the default thing that that you can understand, that if your org with which you belong, it's suspended, you cannot do certain activities like these. So this is all about org. So let's go ahead and create the org. So what name you want to give, you can give anything for the test purposes. I am giving it green learner test, right? Create org. When you are in org, you can see the different things here, right? Memory, account, SI account, so, right? This one, green learner test, org home, right? So this is the development. These are the spaces that are available with you, right? So by default, you get the 2 GB space that you can use, right? So space you see the org, and inside that there are spaces. So let's see what are these spaces and how this default space gets created and how we can create our own new spaces, right? So see the details of the space. A space provides users with access to shared location for app deployment, app development and maintenance. So this is the place actually where you work, a user work, and org contain multiple spaces. Every app, service and route is scoped to a space, right? So org managers can set quotas on the following for a space. What are the kind of paid services that are available to particular space? Name of the app instance, name of service keys, number of routes available with the space, number of reserved route ports, memory used across the space, and memory used by a single app instance. These are the things that org managers can decide about the space that they have. So let's go ahead and see how we can create the new space, right? So this is the, without space you cannot do anything. That is why after creating an org, PCF system has already created a space for us, that is development. We can create our own space, right? So you can go ahead and create the new space. Test, this is any logical name that you can have, right? So yeah, now we have. So these are the details about the number of apps that this number of space, this development or test space has. These are the app status. Green means they are running properly. This means stop, and this means they are crashed. And this is the services. So what are services, we will see in the future videos, right? This was the about setup. So we have registered with the PCF and we are good to go. Now we can go ahead and log into the PCF. Before logging that, let's explore more about the org and spaces, right? So let's understand this in this way. So if this is the PCF, this big rectangle square is the PCF, right? Inside that we have orgs, right? Different spaces, different compartments kind of thing, right? These are the different orgs available. So in, when you are logging to the PCF, you can have multiple orgs as well, right? So depending on the divisions that you want to have in your system. So suppose this is the O1, this is the O2, this is the O3, and this is the O4. And inside these individual orgs, you will have spaces, right? Different spaces. You can have one space, two space, three space, four space, depending on the organization, large organization that you have and different teams that you have. So inside these spaces, you actually work. Whatever app you push, whatever app you deploy belongs to this space. So this goes like this: org space, and inside the space you get the place where you work. All right. So this is the detail, and this is the difference between org space and individual space that you have to work, right? So I hope you understood this. Still you have any confusion, put that in comment section. So I'm going ahead and logging into this system. This is the command line window that I already have opened. So you enter the mail ID greenlearner01@gmail.com, right? So whatever email ID you have, you can enter this, and after this it will ask for the password Arvind0. Authenticating password incorrect. So you have to enter the correct password. Okay, so authenticated, right? So it has targeted this org. So I have only one org, that is why it by default pointed me to the green learner test, right? But we have two space, right? That is why it is not sure where space, which space to go. So I have to choose which space to go. So for example, I want to go to the development, so I have to choose one, right? So I can enter one, and now I am logged in into the system, and it is giving me the details that where I am logging. Targeted space this, API endpoint is this, right? User is this, org is this, and development is this, space is this, right? So now I am under, if I am I show this in to you in the dashboard, so I am in org, we have two spaces, and which space I want to work with? So test space, right? So I am here from our CLI, I am at this point, right? So anything I do will get reflected here, right? So I hope things are clear for now. So I have environment is set up and we can do many things with our PCF environment, right? So I can see there are no apps installed on the this space. So next command to check its CF apps, what this is going to do, you can see getting apps in or this and space this as this user, right? So PCF is very much concerned with the security. Security comes by default. So every user that it has defined role and what it can do with the environment. That is why it has clear lines that what it can, what it has access to. When you are entering this CF apps, right, it is saying you that getting apps in this org and this space as user this, right? So it is giving you the, all the details. So this is the org and space that you are logged in with this user. So whatever apps you have access to, this user has access to, will be reflected here, right? So as of now there are no apps, that is why you're not getting anything. So in the next video I'm going to post the Hello World application with the PCF and show you how this is working. So to post the application, we have this command CF post, right? So and the things will work. You enter this command CF post and set back, everything will be done by the CF CLI and then PCF environment, and you will get a URL with which you can access your application that you have, right? So this is the beauty of the CF, right? Cloud Foundry, you get things very quickly and very easily. So if you want to see other videos that I have uploaded, so this is the playlist that you can go ahead, and this is the Green Learner page on GitHub where I am posting all the source code wherever applicable and putting the videos topic wise whatever, and you can see the entire course plan here, right? So I'll see you in the next video. Take care.